Translating words into symbols, level 1. To solve problems using algebra, it is important that you become comfortable translating mathematical phrases written in words and rewriting them using the language of algebra. In other words, we are taking words that have a specific mathematical meaning and translating it by using mathematical symbols such as numbers and variables. Alright, we are going to systematically go through each mathematical operator and learn how to translate specific phrases into mathematical symbols. Let's start with addition. The common phrases that correspond to addition are the words sum, as in the sum of 5 and x, increased, as in a number increased by 5, and more, as in 5 more than a number. Notice that the variable is sometimes explicitly stated, like in the first phrase, where we need to use the variable x. Notice that some phrases don't explicitly tell you what the variable should be assigned to. In this case, you have complete freedom to choose your favorite letter of the alphabet. Typically, we use the letter n, which represents the word number. Alright, let's move along with the opposite of addition, subtraction. The common phrases that are associated with subtraction are the words difference, as in the difference between a number and 5, decreased, as in a number decreased by 5, less, as in 5 less than a number, and minus, as in 5 minus a number. When translating phrases that involve subtraction, many students have a hard time translating phrases with the word less. Many students translate 5 less than a number as 5 minus x, which is completely wrong. The correct way is x minus 5, because it's 5 less than a number. So you take the number and subtract 5. Okay, let's move along to multiplication. The common phrases that are related to multiplication are the words product, as in the product of 5 and a number, times, as in 5 times a number, and words that explicitly state that we are taking a fraction apart of a number, as in 1/5 of a number. Notice that this last expression can be simplified as n over 5. But for the most part, write it as a product, then simplify. This is going to be important when we work on slightly more complicated phrases. Alright, let's transition to our final operator, division. The common phrases that are linked to division are the words quotient, as in the quotient of a number and 5, and the word divided, as in a number divided by 5. Notice that division can be written using a fraction bar or with the traditional division symbol. For the most part, this classical division symbol will be used less and less in your studies of mathematics. Nevertheless, it will pop up every now and then. At times, a phrase can have more than one mathematical operation, such as the phrase 5 less than half of x. Here we have a difference because of the key word less, and we have a multiplication because we are taking a fraction apart of a number. This expression can also be simplified as follows. In the same manner, the phrase half the difference between x and 5 contains a product because the phrase is denoting that we are taking a fraction apart of a number. In this case, the number is the difference between x and 5, or x minus 5. Notice that we use grouping symbols, specifically parentheses, to group the number that is composed by the difference between x and 5. In addition to translating phrases into mathematical expressions, you also need to be able to effectively work with formulas. Formulas are equations that state rules about relationships. A typical formula that you should be familiar with is the formula to find the area of a rectangle. A is equal to L times W, where A is the area, L is the length of the rectangle, and W is the width of the rectangle. In addition, the formula to find the perimeter of a rectangle is expressed as follows. 2 times the length plus 2 times the width. In other words, you add the lengths of all the sides of the rectangle. Another typical equation that is used in algebra is the distance formula. The distance traveled by an object going at a constant rate for a specific time interval is given by the formula d equals rt, where d is the distance, r is the rate of the object, and t is the time interval the object has been traveling. Finally, to find the monetary cost of a certain number of items, we use the formula C equals NP, where N represents the number of items and P represents the price per item. When using formulas, you need to be comfortable with two types of answers that formulas tend to generate. One of them are numerical expressions and the other are variable expressions. For example, say that we would like to find the area of a rectangle whose length is 10 feet and width is 5 feet. Then we use the formula to find the area of a rectangle and substitute the value for the length and width using grouping symbols, as follows. Then we evaluate the numerical expression for a final answer of 50 square feet. The other types of answers that can be obtained from formulas are variable expressions. For example, say we take the same problem, the width is still 5 feet, but now the length is equal to x. In this case, we once again substitute each variable in the formula with the corresponding value that we are given. In this case, the width is equal to 5, and the length is equal to x. So our final answer is 5x. This variable expression represents the area of the rectangle with the given measurements. Notice that this expression is written in terms of the variable x. At first, writing the area this way seems a bit confusing and weird. But all it says is that the area of this rectangle is 5 times x. In the same manner, the perimeter of the rectangle with the same measurements is equal to 2 times 5 plus 2x. Simplifying the variable expression gives us a final answer equal to 10 plus 2x. Again, notice that the answer is left in terms of the variable x. This expression represents the perimeter of a rectangle with width of 5 and length equal to x. The reason why we want to leave our answer in terms of the variable is because by doing this, we can generate all the areas and perimeters of a rectangle with width 5 and any length that we would like to have. So if I wanted to know the area of a rectangle with width 5 and length of 6, I just take the variable expression 5x and substitute x for 6. And it turns out that it is equal to 30 square feet. In the same manner, if I wanted to know the perimeter, I take the expression 10 plus 2x and substitute x for 6, and I get 22 feet. In algebra, we sometimes don't want to know the exact value, like 30 square feet or 22 feet. We just want to know in general what the perimeter and area would equal to, given a particular width and any length imaginable. So we use a variable to represent the varying nature of the length. Now let's say that you are riding a bike and you travel h plus c hours at a constant rate of 20 miles per hour. How far did you travel? So since we are riding at a constant speed, we use the distance traveled formula, which is equal to the rate times the time, and substitute each expression accordingly. Doing that, we have that the distance traveled is equal to 20 times the quantity h plus c, and this is our final answer. Remember, all we want is a general expression for the distance traveled in terms of the given variables. We don't care about specific numbers, just a general algebraic expression for the distance. Okay, let's do one more example using the cost formula. Say that you decided to buy 3 hamburgers, and each one costs P dollars. What is the total cost of your purchase? So to find the cost, we take the number of items, in this case 3, and multiply it by the price per item, which is equal to P. So the final answer is 3P. Notice that we don't actually have a monetary value. We have a generalized variable expression. But if we knew what P was, then we can find out what the total cost would be. All we need to do is to take the price and multiply it by 3. It is important that you start developing this skill to think algebraically and generalize phrases in terms of variables. Even if you don't know what the particular variable is equal to, we really don't care, unless the problem is asking us to evaluate the variable with a particular value in mind. Okay, in our next video, we will go over even more examples and practice translating words into symbols.